Hello, my name is Dr. Ved, and I am the Research Imaging Specialist in Imaging Core Facility at University of Texas, Dallas. Today, we'll be discussing about how to use the Virtual Slide Scanner Microscope software. In the first module, we'll be learning on how to do bright field imaging. In the module number two, you'll be learning how to do fluorescence imaging. To be honest, this is the easiest microscope to operate. Because the software is fully automatic and the microscope is also. On top of that, the microscope is closed into a big chamber. You just have to load the samples and almost all the imaging will be done automatically. So I would say it's the most used workhorse of our facility. To switch on the microscope, the first button is here. There's a power button. And number two is the brain of the microscope, which is here. Next, you can switch on the CPU. In case you are doing fluorescence imaging, you will be needing to switch on a few more switches, which we'll be covering in the module number two. But for now, you can just switch on these two buttons and the CPU. Once the computer is ready to be run, you can log in using your net ID and password. And meanwhile, you can open the box here, which is these two boxes. If you open these two, you can actually see the cassettes where you can load all the slides. You can load up to 100 slides in one go, and you can see the objectives here. So you can see that it is a upright microscope where the bright field light comes from the bottom and goes into the camera up here. And if you see that the slides are supposed to be kept in such a way that the cover slip is facing towards the top, and accordingly you have to load it in the cassette. So when you are loading, make sure that the labels are pointing towards outside and the cover slip is facing towards the top. And another quick tip, make sure that your slides are at room temperature and are clean, because if they are not at room temperature, say suppose they are just coming out of fridge, then most probably they will start accumulating condensed water vapor, and it will not allow the robotic arm to stick to carry it from here to the stage. So I would highly recommend that keep it on this platform for a while, let it thaw to the room temperature, and then you can load it in the cassette. Once you are done with loading the slides in the cassette, then you can click on this desktop icon. If you are a first time user, then you might see this kind of a dialog box. But if you have been using the software for quite long, or at least the second time, then you may not see this, because this is an agreement which the software wants from your side. I usually never read it. If you want to read it, you're most welcome. You accept this terms and conditions, click continue. Then click OK as a power user. This is how the software interface will look like. There are a lot of tiny buttons, don't worry about them. The major area which we will be focusing upon is this area. For now, we'll be doing the single scan mode. If you zoom in, this is how it looks like. So single slide scan or batch scan. First, we'll do single slide scan. Once you have mastered this area, then we'll move on to the batch scan. So for now, we'll click on expert. Once you do that, then this is what it will show, either to load manually or to load it automatically. Usually we recommend doing automatic load. So if you click that, then it will scan through. It will make pee 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 kind of a sound. And after some time, this box will open where you can see the options, like the locations where the slides have been loaded. So click on any of the option that you want to, like, or the slide that you want to image, and click OK. After you do that, then you can put in the name of the slide and all the details about it. Whatever name you put in here will be used as the image name. You can add more separators by clicking this option, and more information about these will be loaded into the name. Also, the saving location, you can temporarily store it in the e-drive, but make sure that after the imaging is done, you move the files into interdepartmental L-drive under this address, because this computer is not supposed to be used as a storage location. And also, we have a data retention policy of 30 days, that after 30 days, your data may be automatically erased without further notice. Next, you click overview. The microscope will automatically take a 2x image, go back and forth, and create this large scale image. If you feel that all the object has not been covered in this area, say suppose there is something which is left over here, you can actually click this button here. It is inactive right now, but in previous slide it was active. So you can go back and click this, and then it will ask you go to the top corner, left corner, and go to the right bottom corner, and it will again acquire the overview image. After the overview is taken, now you have the option of choosing the magnification and the kind of Z scan mode that you want to do. If you are doing a 10x and just one plane, then you can choose this option. If you want to do other magnification, you can choose any of those. This is for the CD data volume, if you have different Z stacks. This one will be useful if you want to create just one plane image out of that CD. This is basically extended focus imaging. It will take a little bit more time compared to the first one, but of course it will give you a better result. After this, you click next. As you can see that the software has done pretty good job in identifying the object, but I am not happy with the selection. I would like to edit it, so I would edit the scan area. If I click that, now I can change the box size, I can add more boxes or whatever. Say suppose I could also image here and here and everywhere else if I want to, by dragging and creating new boxes. This is the kind of focus logic it will be following. Right now it is going to only image the object here. You can see very thin white line here, means it has actually done a very good job in sample detection. In case your sample detection is not very good, you can actually go for this option or this option, where it is going to do a brute force method. It is going to image the entire thing. Once you are done, then you click edit focus map. Now you can see how many focal points would you like to have in the image. I know for sure that this object is very, very flat, so just a few spots will be good enough. But in case your object is not in the single plane, then you can have more focal points, or you can simply click and add, or if you want to have lesser, then you can select these and delete these. Okay. Then once you are done with this, then click on this button. Now you are all set to start the imaging. You can click scan now. After the scanning is done, you can zoom in as much as you want, just like Google Maps. This area you can consider as village, and this area you can consider as city. This is actually a merged image where there are two different layers, 10x image and 2x image. You can see definitely this is less noisy, and this one has got better resolution compared to 2x. If you are happy with this image, well and good. If you are not happy, you can add more scans and this will automatically take you back to this position. If you are happy with this image, then you can scan a new slide, or you can save finish. And before you do that, I would recommend saving this project. What it will do, it will save all the settings that you have used so far as a file, so that you can use it for batch scanning, or you can reuse it for imaging another similar slide. Okay, so with that, we come to the end of single imaging in the bright field. Now we'll try doing some batch mode. So after save and finish, you can click on expert batch. If you do that, then it will open up the same slide loader option, where you can select the slides that you want to do, and then you can input the names. You can click next after that. Then you can select the slides whichever you want to image, click this option, and now from there you can import the settings file, which you can impose on all of these selected slides by clicking this option. This one. This will put in all the slides. This will be doing on the selection. Once you are done, then automatically all of these parameters will be loaded here. And now you can click overview. So it will do an overview of all the slides. Then once you are done with the overview, it will give you an opportunity to do the area selection and the focus maps and things like that. Once you are done with that, then you click OK, and it will do all the imaging just like these, and it will automatically save the files in the location that you had selected. And by the way, after imaging is done, you won't see the images opened up here. It will be automatically saved and closed. So if you don't see any images, don't freak out. It's already saved and safe. Only in the single imaging mode you will be seeing these kinds of tabs. Okay, so with that we come to an end of the module number 1. In module number 2, as discussed, we'll be covering the fluorescence imaging.